Well, time now for the men's Epée gold medal match. And this is going to be a matchup between Russia and Korea. Point to the Russian. Good work by the Russian in the end there, and reaches the target score of 5. So 5-3 to Team Russia. Early days. Of course, new rules in Epée this season. The non-combativity rules mean that you have to hit within a minute of fencing, and a double saves us from that worry in this particular leg, because we're less than a minute left on the clock. Nice hit from Yang. So often when the scores are tied like this, no one wants to give away the lead as they hand over to their teammate. So often they will gentlemanly step aside, but Yang's not going to do that. He wants to keep this honest right to the very last second, and they step away, and it is 9 apiece. 10 was the target, so they were just one below that. But good work from the Korean Jang Min Hyuk. So that double brings us into double figures. Epée, the only weapon where you can score a double. And the rule of the game, really much hit but do not be hit. It's not like in Sabre and Foil where you want to hit with the right of way. You want to initiate the attack, finish with a hit. In Epée, it's really about trying to find a way to hit your opponent without their opponent being able to hit you. And you can do that by beating the blade on the way in to the attack, just as Lee did there, and opening up a line of attack. And just watch the footwork here from Lee. When he needs to be, he can be explosively quick. Two-step shuffle, then a jump forward, and then launched into that flesh attack. Footwork 75% of fencing. It really is. You've got to make sure that you've got the distance right before you launch your attack. It's all about getting yourself into the right position, stepping in at the right time, stepping back out at the right time. Imagine if the fencers had a bungee cord attached around each of their waists, and when it was too slack, you're too close. If it's too stretched, you're too far away. Only when it's just right have you gained the timing to attack. Well, as the clock ticks down, we are going to go out of the third and into the fourth. Score sits at 13-10. Yang has pressed the accelerator button, definitely. Yeah, he's really going after the Russian now. Korean coach Choi has given Yang the instruction to take the fight to the Russian. They would have watched them fence in the individual competition, they would have watched them fence in the team event. They know who they fancy to score points off. And Korea are really on a roll now. 8 points the deficit. And Shvelidze not able to register a single point yet in this fourth leg. Double. A double scored. Still no single light for the Russian. Casual from Yang. Well, Shvelidze looking for the blade, looking to try and beat the blade on the way through. Just couldn't find it. Yang so fast, racing to that target score of 20. So the score sits at 20-11. A massive, massive win in leg four there at 7-1. Yan Min Hyuk did a great job for his team there. But last 2 points have gone to Russia. Single lights. Still a 10-point deficit. And Jang is just one away from the target score of 25. Oh, lovely. Lovely little flick over the top of the guard. Brings us to 25-13. It's bit of a whitewash, unfortunately. Now they've got such a commanding lead, 5-2. That one's won. Russian able to come around from the outside to in and hit right in the center of Lee's chest. Well, Gusev certainly going for it. Double scored will help Lee get to 1 point away from the target score of 30. And Gusev has scored 5 now, so another point for the Russian. And it'll be into kind of bonus clawback territory. So 10, just 10 the deficit now. It was a 12-point gain when Gusev took it over. Double will see us out, so 30-19. So 5 points scored by Lee. We are into the final third of this competition. Seventh leg. Ah. and the Russians really going to have to throw a bit of caution to the wind, because they cannot go into the last two legs with a 10-point deficit. Needs to be manageable, especially when we are kind of at the top level. We are on top of the scoreboard. We're a high-scoring game. Doesn't leave much room on the scoreboard for the Russians to play catch-up. Well, two good points there for Team Russia. And Yan Min-hook, he did very, very well in the fourth leg. He's coming into this on a plus eight indicator, but he has allowed the Russian to score four unanswered points. So change of tactic perhaps required for the Korean. If it keeps going like this, the Russians could get back into it. There's another one. Now, Yan Min-hook just looking to the box, looking to the coach, searching for some advice. Yeah, finally Yan getting one on the board. Yeah, so the score started in this seventh leg, 30-19. It's now 31-24, so a great catch-up job by the Russians. Thought Yan had fallen short there, but just continued on with the attack. Tries the same thing. Fards enough wise to it that time. The ducking counter. So 6 points scored now by Fardzinov to the, just the three of Yang. That's better work from the Korean. And although he didn't change his tactic in the second half of this leg, he's changed his execution. How did he get that one on target? How did he actually manage to hit Fardzinov there? Pronated the wrist upwards. 35-25 the score, and 6-5 in the end. So 1 point only clawed back by the Russians. And a 10-point lead going into the eighth, the penultimate leg, as they test their guards and mask up and get ready to go. Korea in a commanding lead. It's Lee Sheng-hyun on against Dmitry Shvelidze. And Lee immediately getting the scoreboard ticking over. 35-25. And 40 is the target.
Pre.
So now 36-25. Lovely hit from Lee. The Koreans looking very comfortable now. Body language. Relaxed and confident in the box. Wow, nice point for the Russian there. Flash attack from Lee. Well, Lee came into this with a +2 indicator. And he is accelerating away towards that target score of 40. Double scored. The first attack from Lee was parried. He was able to regain his composure while flying through the air. Oh, acrobatic stuff from the Korean. So 39-28. And that's it, 40-28 the score now. So 5-3 in that leg. So Lee finishing on a +4 indicator. Dmitry Shvaledze finishing on a -6. So the anchor men are on. Dmitry Gusev for Russia and Yang Hyo-min for Korea. But at 40-28, it would require a miracle for the Russian team. And Yang's not going to hang around. Well, on paper, Gusev has been the Russians' best fencer. Comes in with a -1 indicator.
En garde. Prêt. Allez.
And Gusev will do his best to get the scoreline looking respectable in this final leg. Ah. Ah. They went core, referee called halt before Gusev could hit the Korean. Double scored. So the Korea is just 3 points away now. And of all the fencers, the Koreans have given the most respect to Gusev. Just backing off, making sure. And Yang able to hit there. 2 points now needed for Korea to clinch the gold medal. Single light. And that is it, 45-31. A convincing victory for the Koreans. Absolutely ecstatic with that gold medal. And it really did just from the moment that they were able to extend the lead, they tied up in the second period, 9 apiece, and then just slowly edged ahead. And it was great work from all of the Korean fencers there. And in fact, all the Koreans finished it on plus indicators, and well-deserved gold medalists as we look at some of the replays from that gold medal match. It just slipped away from the Russians and they never had a chance of really regaining. And the Koreans were just too good. Done to the men's team Epée medal winners as they get a chance to pose for the photos. We can confirm that it was Republic of Korea in gold, Russia in silver, and Italy in bronze.